Hi everyone, welcome to Shadow Warrior 2. I've played Shadow Warrior 1 and I played Shadow Warrior Classic. Didn't manage to beat Shadow Warrior 1 ever. I think I did beat Shadow Warrior Classic though at some point. I've never done that on YouTube or something. So this is a blind run I'm doing, and I'm going to be doing this in co-op with Pat, but unfortunately I have to play the prologue without him, so we're going to just kind of run in. We are playing on Who Wants Wang. It raises the damage of some things. It's kind of insane to 70% more damage, 80% more HP, and things like that. We're gonna definitely keep it on hard for the time being. And that's normal. That's easy, but we're playing on hard, as I said, so. So, welcome to the game, guys. And I'm already aware of how to play the game. I'm already like 2 hours into it, but I figured I should do the tutorial just so you guys can kind of see what is the deal with this game.
All right, where the fuck is this thing?
So, if you're aware of anything about the first Shadow Warrior, was it's heavy emphasis on melee combat, but it's got the guns in there too. We start with the revolver and we start with the Uzi. The animations, by the way, are just kind of amazing as well. Very, very good. Very solid animations. The company that made this is Wild Hog and the Flying Hog, no Wild Hog. They did some stuff like the I don't know if you guys didn't know, I did hard reset at one point, like the game. Unfortunately, the company that did it, they didn't do much else with hard reset, unfortunately. But I did like it a lot, that game. I've never gone this way. Well, I found a secret, what do you know? Wish I'd went this way beforehand. I kinda looked at it now and I'm like that. So there's secrets in this game. What do you know? So we gotta find them all, I guess, or something. So the sword combat is very nice. It's kinda based upon the way you look as well. And or the way you move. That's kinda the way it works. Kinda neat how that works. Also, there's no falling damage. And we do little rolls and stuff.
Oh man, if you guys get any more ugly, I'm gonna have to start killing you blindfold.
And that's telling us about some special melee moves. So this is a thrust attack, so you have to let that charge up. Damn. Now spinning can be a little bit disorienting, but kind of a fun move. They do a lot of great stuff like this, and the fact that this game is co-op is even better.
You're full of holes.
And so here we have the little statue that returns my chi. Also, get used to the great humor of the game. You guys are gonna love it. Trust me. Yeah, let me through here. We also have health regeneration. You know, just in case you needed it. Yeah, it's this guy.
Oh, how nice for me. Shit. Fuck off. I hate it when they do that.
I kind of didn't want to do that one. As far as I know, there's really no restrictions on how many times I dodge around as a dude. But I would say the story of this game is probably the backseat of this of why this is a great game. So far, I really like it, I have to say. It's more about the combat and more about just the humor. The humor is actually the best part, to be honest. Let's just regenerate my health a little bit. By the way, that doesn't necessarily free. See how it's like my mana or chi, whatever it is, 29 now. And yeah, not particularly coming back. You have to kill something or do something else. But up thugs with their faces so ugly, stomping on demons who want all that snuggly, shooting at nightmares that fly with their wings. These are a few of my favorite things. Wolves up, yeah, there we go. And here we have some more tutorial-y stuff. Don't worry, Pat will be joining us very soon. He's just not here right now. Kind of a nice game. I will explain some of the menus and stuff when we get a chance, actually. Because this very actually gives you very much a Borderlands-y vibe, to be honest. I'll just deal with those. I would say it's probably one of the direct inspirations, which, I mean, to be honest, the itemization isn't necessarily what... It wasn't what I didn't like about Borderlands all the time. It was a lot of other stuff, kind of the story being repetitive, you play through it 2-3 times, and things like that, eh. And also the game was fairly easy. This one actually has a pretty solid difficulty level so far, but it is a cooperative thing, so... Wait, we have a gem here. So I'll show you how this guy works. So, we have a possibility of 8 different weapons. Doesn't matter where the weapons are. I can have, if I have 3 Uzis, I can have 3 Uzis. It just kind of all the ammunition count kind of like consolidates, so... Having 3 Uzis is simply inefficient because they're all using the same ammunition type. But these are the only 3 weapons we have at the very moment. We'll get another one soon. And we have weapon upgrades. And so part of what this game does is you can either kind of junk it. It says recycle, but I'm not sure if it actually gives us the money for it because it actually has a sell value. But what you can do is you can go, hey, I can decide what weapon I want it in. Okay. Let's put plus 4% damage in my sword. Raise the DPS to 76.4. Kind of nice. And you can get different kind of levels of qualities of these gems. Different levels of quality of the... this is like just a gray, simple default weapon. So you can get like really powerful variations of these upgrades and things like that. So that's it for that. Then we have skills. We got life mastery. We get increases drops from medkits or just total hit points. We got these two are 4-year sword combo. So either you do the 360 spin technique. You've seen me use both of these or the stabbing technique. I like that stabbing technique the best. The vortex is kind of meh to me. Yeah. And then this one is a healing flame. That's my little health regeneration thing that I've been using. It would increase my healing time and the amount of time it takes to come up. Some chi capacity stuff, so that's like your total mana. Increase the amount of ammo found. Increase the total amount of karma. I'm going to max that first because I think it's one of those ones where you know, you level that early and you get much more experience kind of like early on. I think it's like, yeah, pays off later. And increases maximum amount of carried bullets and auto collect radius is increased. So that's kind of nice. I think that's it for all these places, yeah. Oh yeah, there's a Wanglopedia, which is just has a bunch of... I've actually gotten all these weapons, I just realized, I've gotten them in my other run that is ongoing, that is going to, you're going to see in a second. I just didn't know how this first part would be, so I fucked it up and I decided to re-record it. Just wanted to show you guys the tutorial. What was I going on about? I don't know. Yeah, we're not going to do much, we're not going to look at the Wanglopedia at all, because it's just, like, it's just lore stuff, just know it has a lot of it. And you can read through it anytime you like, if you buy the game. Oh, man, yeah! But I'm not much into the lore kind of stuff, so I'm not really probably gonna really pay attention to that kind of things all that much. But it is a blind run, so as I said, we don't know what to expect. All the bosses and stuff are gonna be very much new to us, so.
Oh, hey, you guys. You need directions? Just take a sharp left through my sword and keep on going.
You can parry as well. I forgot how to do that. Whoops. Oh, and I totally fucked that up. Ow. Take a sharp left through my sword, though.
Nice work. You deserve a hand for that. Oh, look. Here's one someone's not using anymore.
All right, well, we're done with that area. So you can sprint or you can just dash everywhere. It doesn't really matter. All the same shit to us. All right, let's get the fuck out then. Oh, the bunny blood splatter is still there.
Mamushi Heika may be a cold-blooded sociopathic mob boss, but she knows how to decorate. Hello? Hello? Jesus, this a party or was there a toxic spill?
Perhaps you will realize her destiny.
Fascinating.
Or you'll get your chance.
I see.
There has been an incident, Mr. Wang.
Smith, what are you doing here? You work for this beat? Nice lady, too?
I am in no one's employ but my own.
You two know each other?
Smith is my mechanic. Fix my car a few dozen times.
I am here on personal business. Kamiko has gone missing.
The birthday girl? Does that mean no cake?
It's gonna mean no balls for you if you don't shut your yammering mouth.
Ah, oh, I see what's going on. The big boss's daughter got lost on your watch. Do I smell a beheading? More importantly, do you think they'll sell tickets?
I'm afraid the situation is quite serious. For some time, she's been worried that Zilla has found her out. And today she was due at my garage at 4. She is never late.
Whoa, 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 rewind. Zilla? Orochi-Zilla?
Yes. She was working in his labs, undercover.
Oh, he doesn't like that kind of thing.
I'm organizing a rescue mission.
Zilla's security is legendary. They wouldn't get past the front desk.
And what would you suggest?
Go in quiet. You send one guy, preferably one that knows his way around.
Are you offering your services?
Depends on what you're paying.
100,000. Cash.
Ah, that should please my accountant. I still have a few old badges and a couple fakes. I can get in and at least tell you what you're dealing with.
Go then, find out what happened. Bring her back if you can.
Back here?
No. This is the first place they'll look. Take her to...
I have a secluded location you may use.
Okay then, take her to the old man's place.
Bring her to my garage, I'll meet you there.
What do you want me to do with this?
I can give it to her. Want to see her?
Lo Wang?
Yes.
Don't fuck this up. If she dies, they'll be picking your fingertips out of my gardens for weeks.
Lady sure knows how to motivate her workforce.
Intimidation is the tool of the fearful heart.
Hey, beats being the fool of the tearful fart.
That's deeply stupid.
But it's true.
Fair enough.
Get out of here!
I like these two guys. Alright, let's claim a reward from the butler here. Got your trinket. Does that mean I deserve cake? I guess not. We got a shotgun out of it, and a skill point, and some money. We just got our shotgun, and that just takes up another weapon slot, and we also have a skill point, so... I'm not sure if I did in the video, the stuff with Pat, therefore after, but I'm gonna put that definitely into Karma right away. We can use those bonuses right away. It's either you get it early on or never. So I'm gonna shoot this guy in the face for it. Thank you. I was bleeding everywhere. Alright. Anyways, so Pat's gonna join me now, so thanks, and here we go. Alright guys, we loaded it up, and Pat's fucking just wrecking shit.
I'm finding money everywhere.
Do I look like a green ninja to you?
Yeah, you look like fucking green Deadpool. How did you do that?
Yeah, you're fucking red Deadpool. It's a multiplayer setting. Apparently,
hold on. Hold on. Shut up.
High noon, motherfucker.
Okay, did I change?
Not yet, but I'm sure you'll change a little later. And apparently we just phase through each other, apparently.
Yeah, no, stop moving. Look, when we get close to each other, we start to fade.
Yeah, I think it's so that you don't, like... you know, I can imagine in a hectic game like this, it's very close quarters. It's actually probably for the best. It works this way. Pat...
Maybe.
Pat, the Yukuzo's gonna fucking kill us. You can't do this.
They're already going to kill us.
So, interesting fact, I have the GOG version, Pat has the Steam version. Connecting was not that simple. And hopefully there was a two-player limit on it. Was there a two-player limit on it?
I don't know.
Oh, good. I'm glad you didn't check that. So if someone else joins our game, then we're probably just gonna fucking get angry. I have it set to two-player difficulty, so I assume it's like that. So, he had to join a public game, because he can't... I couldn't figure out how to make it join on an invite. Or anything like that, so... yeah. Where are you going?
I'm looking around. I figured you were just talking about stupid shit, so I'm gonna look for secrets and shit.
Why the fuck do you, like... You're fucking phasing in and out while you're jumping. Oh, because you're fucking dashing, I guess.
Yes.
Is that how that works? That's fucking weird, dude. Alright, let's go then.
I look for secrets. It's what I do.
Oh, yeah, and... I bet.
And I go straight to the fucking loading screen. There's like no warning or anything. It's just straight to the loading screen. That's awesome.
Well, because I pressed the thing to continue, so I guess we're gonna have to be kind of careful.
Yeah, but it didn't ask me for my opinion.
Well,
it just forced it on me.
Fuck your opinion. That's why.
Okay.
I'm assuming the loot is separate for both of us.
I'd hope so.
Well, I assume it is. Okay, so apparently it will not load for me until you're loaded. I assume you're loaded now?
Yeah, it's synchronizing network data.
Okay. That's what it says for you right now?
Yes.
Oh, because I just have press any key to continue. Are you here?
Yeah, it's just press any key to continue. Holy shit.
Welcome
yeah.
to the shiny, happy future.
Dude, is this Deus Ex?
It must be. Yeah, I got a fortune cookie. The Bible tells us to be like God, and then on page after... It describes God as a mass murderer on the page after. Okay. Fucking edgy shit.
Confusion is a word. We have something. I didn't read it up because you were reading yours and I didn't want to read it because then I wouldn't have read it.
Okay. You went to Reddit, huh?
No.
Alright. I guess we should go to the objective place. Or actually, wait. There's a thing here. Where's the... it's just below us. Do you see on the mini-map there's some icons here?
Yeah. I just dashed up. Well, you took the stairs. I did the cool way.
Okay. Well, go fuck yourself. We got a component here, and I guess I'm gonna go... I guess I haven't kind of put in anything yet.
Damage. That's right. Skill points.
Yeah, I was thinking of... Oh, miss rate? -5.6? How's that work?
Oh, fucking auto-aim! You're gonna be the fucking auto-aim king.
Apparently.
Where do you even see that one at?
It was one of the upgrade. It was the upgrade I just got. So for my first skill point, I think I'm gonna put that into increased maximum karma. I don't know. It just seems like a nice thing to invest in early on, you know.
Maybe.
All right.
What did you put it in?
I put it into karma. Because karma is, I think, what is the experience in this game.
Okay, that sounds good.
There is a lot of open areas here for places that we don't even need. Like, what's down here? Who the fuck knows? Apparently nothing, it's just blackness.
Fuck! 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 I'm dead.
Alright. Yeah, okay, you first death, alright. Well, that's actually...
Yeah, I hit an invisible wall.
So what happens when you die?
I don't know, I just reappeared.
You're kind of invisible. What the fuck? You're a completely different person now. You're fucking edgy as shit. Nice.
It's just so hard to find a good forge these days.
I was trying to do some fancy dancy jumping shit, because I saw an open area below us, like, that you could jump down and dash into, and then as soon as I did it, I hit an invisible wall.
Oh, they're gonna have that, probably. Access denied.
Note to self. I see it again.
Kill your fucking forger.
So what does it do to raise the difficulty? I hope it spawns more enemies.
I don't know.
Alright, I'm gonna
show you. Seems just about as easy as it was before.
I'm gonna show you something kind of cool, guys. With your shotgun, Pat, try this. With your shotgun, fire one shot and reload it. Actually, no, it didn't work. What the fuck? Oh, it did. Yeah, it doesn't work. What the fuck? I swear it works. It was actually one of the best. Oh, there we go. That's the animation. Okay, I guess it just does it randomly.
Have you ever tried reloading your sword?
Yeah, you wipe it off. Yeah, it's good shit.
My character doesn't do that.
What does your character do? Well, I can't.
Oh, no. Okay, this time she just wiped it off, but last time she stuck it between her legs.
The fuck?
Yeah.
Good shit, Pat. I don't think that's where the sword goes, I'm just gonna tell you right now. I'm gonna guess that you sound like Wang right now.
My character doesn't talk.
Oh, so it's just me that talks. Do you hear me talking?
No, I hear it kind of out there.
Are you having issues with these guys?
They're blocking me.
Got to shotgun them both, it's fine.
It was an intense battle.
Better! It looked intense, you looked like you were just like trying to block everything. We got a soul of ice and essence of blow up. Essence of blow up? You for fucking
I just
real?
Opened up this box over here, I hope you know that.
Damage adds explosive material to projectiles. Oh, what the hell? What, all my... Oh, dude, apparently I can have like a... explosive shotgun. Sorry, explosive pistol. Sorry, I meant the pistol. Okay, that's fucking awesome. Alright, so we have elemental upgrades, chilling effect, damage converted to ice on, I guess, the sword. And damage converted to ice again. I have two of these things. Okay, I have like a super ice sword now. What are you doing?
I just opened this box here. Did you open this box?
Yes, I did already. Oh, I guess it doesn't open it for both.
Yeah,
of
it
us.
Doesn't open. Okay, so that's good to know. That's what I was trying to figure out.
Yeah. There's some money here. That's. I assume the drops are separate, to be honest.
Oopsies.
You can actually see all the items on the map, which is something I didn't clue into immediately.
Yeah, I see what you're talking about. I see a bunch of boxes either above or below me.
Yep.
Below me.
So, but it's all separate, so if you don't get a box, then you're...
Did you get the boxes down here?
I'm coming down. Relax.
Okay, I'm making sure. Fucking hell, dude. I'm not gonna talk to you about this shit anymore.
Found frosty substance. So, yeah, it's very Borderlands-y in that sense, but, like, Borderlands was kind of just, I guess, boring, so, you know what? It's different. It's a good kind of difference. Chance to freeze. Wow, dude, okay, I have just the ice katana
ice
here.
Ice Chaos just joined.
Oh, okay, that's not good. Alright. Fuck. Alright. We're gonna quit then.
Fuck!
Did you die again?
Yes.
Why? I've never seen someone die so much when there's like no enemies on the screen.
It's cause I keep doing this like the super double jump backflip thing and I just go flying and it's so stupid.
Super double jump backflip thing?
Yeah. Because I'm trying to be really fast and cool about shit, but then I just end up throwing myself in fucking, like, midair.
Wait, what the fuck are you doing? I don't even understand.
You played the tutorial?
That super double jump, you mean like where you sprint forward, right?
No.
That must be what you're doing, actually.
No, where you basically sprint upwards.
Yeah,
don't worry about
when it. You're in the air, right? Yeah, that's what I see you doing, and you can't control
I'm not
that.
Doing it anymore. Where's that fucking thing?
What fucking thing?
Box.
Whatever. Anyways, guys, we're back. The fix involved Pat refunding the Steam version, getting the GOG version.
Like because you didn't tell me which version we'd be playing, and I'm figuring, okay, Steam versions all the time.
I should say the dev is aware of the issues around private games between the two different clients, but they're that was our solution, and they're apparently going to fix it in the future. So remember, this is a blind playthrough, so we're just doing whatever. Okay, you ready to go?
Yeah.
All right, go fucking you weeb. I'm sniping them from here. Okay, maybe I should just have fun. Oh. What is wrong with this guy? So Pat, tell us what happens when you die.
You just come back.
Okay.
To normal.
So, you see that, actually you can't really see that icon, can you? I was gonna say, do you see that screwdriver kind of icon? You're right on top of it right now. It's on your screen right now.
What screwdriver?
You see that kind of like that screw icon on your minimap right now, right where you are?
Yes.
Yeah, I was so confused on what that was, but it's apparently a checkpoint. That's all it means.
Okay.
Go figure.
Well, that's definitely a thing.
Hey, we got ninjas here. I got
you're using by the way, did you use the advanced like ninja settings for the sword?
I did indeed. Yep.
Okay.
It's basically like the swipe is based upon both your where you're looking
and where you are moving to.
Where you're moving to. It just kind of just picks one, I think. I think it used to be just when you're moving, I think in the original. It's not really original game, but Kind of close enough. So now we won't have any shooters joining us, which is good.
Oh, I can't pick that up. Apparently, only you can.
Future keeps getting futurier. Hey, like it's Andrew Ryan, dude.
Holy shit!
It's a man not entitled to the sweat of his brow.
I tried to get my mom to play that game, and it freaked her out.
Oh, did it?
No.
Why?
I don't know.
Does she not think she's entitled to a sweat of her brow?
Probably not.
You know what that is? It's called communism.
Something I missed here.
You already got everything. Okay. Oh, whenever you're ready, Pat.
Okay.
I love the sword charge up thing. So far, we've been through the game a little bit. It just, despite the...
A little bit?
Well, yeah, trust me, the game's probably going to be long. The thing I did that you didn't hear me mention, did you watch me ever play the Shadow Warrior 1? It's not the classic, but the modern version. Yeah, it's not a remaster. It's a modernization of it, but I think there's a cutscene here, so just watch that first.
Room's locked. Bulletproof glass, too. I wonder if that's...
Oh, Kamiko. My star pupil.
Yeah, of course it's her.
Come now. Calm yourself, my dear. Let you go? I'm afraid I can't do that, my dearest. It would spoil our grand experiment, and you always loved experiments. Before we embark on this grand adventure, there's something I should say. I am deeply in your debt, young lady. I would never have achieved all that I have without your help. The lab just won't be the same without you to steal from. Proceed.
God damn it, Zilla. I knew you were into some twisted shit. This is on a whole other level.
That's strange. What's happening? Is she all right? Someone check her vitals.
Pulse is normal, sir.
Untie her gag. I don't want her suffocating. We need her to be...
Flies carry on the stench of death.
Oh my. Now this is... getting interesting.
Oh shit.
Bulldoze bodies. Open thighs. Dismember children.
Secure the room. I need to examine her in person. I'm on my way.
Yes, sir.
Hey, you guys know a good Mexican place around here?
What? Get him!
Nice.